This is who we are, Mama. Real women. I think there's a lot of things in the film that I think I and a lot of young girls in our culture can relate to. As far as the image issue goes, being bombarded day and night with images of women who you don't see every day, and you come to wonder, what's wrong with us? What's wrong with me? Because I don't look like a model in, you know, in a magazine. And for me, it was even harder because I was pursuing an acting career. You know, as an actor, you're expected to be more beautiful and more perfect than everybody else. And the reality of it is that we're not, and we're nobody different. And, you know, it's hard. There comes a point in your life where you have to, you know, find what makes you love who you are.
It's because I love you that I make your life so miserable.
This is a play that was originally written mm-hmm. for you. Tell me what you had to do different to put it on film.
Well, it's more third dimensional. It takes it out of the sweatshop and into the actual lives of these people. She has a husband she talks about in the play, but here you see her relationship, how she relates to the rest of the family. At first, I really didn't care for it because I think I was misreading that first scene where she's manipulating, that she's this hypochondriac and all that. I did not want this woman to be a caricature. And there was a tendency with the way the scenes were written that it could have been that way. But I wanted it to be more the manipulation, but in a very honest way that she would manipulate.
Don't eat the flan.
The theme that encompasses all of it is loving who you are through your body, what you do, your choices in life. Loving yourself isn't just about the exterior. You know, people are forced into jobs and spend their entire lives doing professions that make them so unhappy. And it's like, why are you living your life for somebody else? Why are you doing something rather than what you know will make you happy? I think that's why all ages and all cultures and all, you know, genders can identify with it, because life never stops going on. You never stop learning. You never stop fighting. You never stop working, you know?
Yo trabajo desde la edad de 13 años. Ana tiene 18 años. Ahora le toca a ella.
It's very much the immigrant story, you know, and this country is made up of immigrants, so it's almost everybody's story at some point. But it is also about, you know, you forming yourself separate from your parents and say, I have to do this. The scene at the end where she wants her mother's blessing and she can't get it, it always makes me cry, because I feel like you really would love to get the approval of your parents. But at some point, you really have to say, no, I guess this is when I become an adult, when I no longer need it. So it is about becoming an adult and sort of embracing your humanity and really taking a stand for your greatness and moving on. It will fulfill one of my commitments, which is to represent Latinos authentically and to have created roles for Latinas that have dignity to them. I hope for the Latino community that, you know, that it's a celebration of our culture. That's what I hope it is.